most important thing that I was worried for my wife, because she was pregnant in the 7 months. So they told me that I have to do tests for her. And thanks for God that she was negative. Wife became pregnant again. When I told my sister that my wife is pregnant and she's a staff nurse and she has been working in this field for 25 years, she got shocked and she told me, yeah, now you feel comfortable because you transmitted the infection to her. I told her that I used the treatment for 3 years, so to transmit the infection, the percentage is so low. And she asked a doctor who has more experience than her, I mean more than 25 years. He told her, I am sure that after 5 years or 10 years, the baby is going to get the infection. At the end, she told me, I'm not going to deliver her. Don't bring her to my hospital. You are going to make a scandal for me because they do the test for her. So it will be shame for me to deliver her in the hospital.
Here at the clinic, just to provide the treatment and care for HIV patients. Since March 2007, we started to receive the patient from all over the country, actually, because we were the first in Sana'a. And we are receiving the patient, give them the treatment, the care, and the counseling also. And the patient, they are suffering from stigma, discrimination, and the main challenge that we are facing in ART site, stigma and discrimination, especially from the community, the family member of the patient, and also from other hospital, and especially from our hospital, this hospital. In the beginning, they refuse to admit patients in the wards. They refuse to see the patient if he need any medical seek or if he seek any medical advice. Now we try. And we tried. We began with courses for doctors and for nurses. We feel that it is lower bit and improved a little bit, but it is still there is discrimination and stigma in the hospitals, community, and family members of the patient.
Exactly, by someone from the hospital in the ART site, he told me that there is an association. It takes care upon people living with HIV. So it was a good chance for me to join this association because they defend upon our rights.
إنشاء مشغل خياطة إنتاجي متكامل في داخل الجمعية للسيدات الأرامل التي ليس لديهم دخل مادي أو شهري أو أزواج أو أهل يعولهن ماديا. هذه من المشاريع التي نقوم بها في الجمعية.
عرفت عن حالتي بعد ما مات زوجي. الوصمة والتمييز. لما يوصلونا في لما تدخل مثلا المستشفى اتعاين انا وبنتي تحصلين المعامله الثانيه ما فيش اهتمام بالمريض لما يكون مريض عكس لما يكون ما فيش في بهذا المرض لا في كمان من ناحيه اجتماعيه كمان من الاهل حتى كمان حصلت وصمه وتمييز من اقرب الناس الي زي الاب ابي يتخلى عني لما عرف المرض دي سيبني خلاص قال لي روحي عيشي مكان ما انت جيتي من المرض هذا روحي مكانه انت وبنتك ما لي دخل بس نفسه كذا بسهوله كانني ما نش بنته بعد ما تخلى بي عني انا تزوجت وتزوجت ومعي ما شاء الله دحين 5-4 بنات ولد لانني انا تعبت بحياة لما عرفت اني مريضه تعبت بمسؤولي لان ما كان فيش معي دخل اصرف على بناتي
فهذا الشيء
اي بس لو كنت انا قادره رجال بروح اشتغل بحصل على وظيفه باي اي حاجه بشتغل فيها بها
HIV problem in Yemen is still low level epidemic. The estimated cases about 30,000 cases, but the number of the cases which is discovered, yes, it is more among men, but the women also affected by HIV, but sometimes they didn't access the surfaces and due to many things, some of them related to stigma and discrimination, some of them is related to the violence of the population against women. So we need to scale up these surfaces for women to discover the cases among women in Yemen. Now, regarding the care and treatment, I think we have enough financial support, but for the other activities, especially for the advocacy and for the awareness for the population, we need more support. We need also we have also a gap regarding the counseling and testing, especially for the prevention of mother to child transmission, which we need also to sustain this services and to scale up the services for more women.
The decision to start a project with HIV here in Yemen has been an interesting one with a bit of a history. Some of the differences for the HIV project here relative to other projects is that the prevalence rate, as you've heard, is really low compared with, for example, in Africa. But one of the main issues for starting a project here is that the stigma and discrimination is very high. This has meant that there's very poor access to service, there's underreporting of cases, and the funding which is being allocated to the services is not high either, so the services are not well developed. The main way that Médecins Sans Frontières will be doing its activities here will be through collaborating with the National AIDS Program. They're the ones who coordinate the activities here, so we'll be looking to support the services that they already run, as well as looking to try and increase and expand the services that are available.